Hey everybody, Thomas Vanderkin, Global Account Manager from Lenovo, back again, with another unboxing video. This time it's the Lenovo Nano. So if you guys are following along, I did a shell unboxing of this thing a while ago. I got the real one now. So this is the ThinkCenter M90n-1 Nano. So I think we're going to be surprised when you pop it open how small this thing is. So we've had our tower desktop for a long time, as you guys are all familiar with. That then moved to the small form factor, which is on your desk. Then Lenovo, again, set a new trend, and we came out with a thing called the Tiny. Super popular, driving a lot of our business in the tiny form factor. Well, we said that's not small enough. Let's come up with something crazy, and now we're shipping this Nano. So there's two versions of it. This is a regular Nano. It's got the fan in it. There's also going to be an IoT version of this, completely fanless, but it's got like fins on top of it, very distinctive when you look at it, but great for a lot of other use cases. Today we're looking at the regular Nano. So let's pop this open. We'll talk a little bit about it. So here we go. Oop. So the tape's already coming loose here. So a little bit about the Nano. So it comes with a few different configurations. There's all the way up to 16 gigabytes. You can get up to a 512 gig hard drive, and you can get a up to an i7 processor in this thing. So let's see what's in the box here. Very small, so what do we have in the first little box here? What do we got? Okay. Bunch of goodies. So looks like an antenna. It's going to be a wireless model. Mouse. The AC adapter here for the Nano. Next in the box, I'm sure this is going to be a keyboard. So let's pop open the keyboard. Okay, here we go. Standard Lenovo keyboard, standard Lenovo mouse, let's open this up, and our AC adapter. But without further ado, let's get to the exciting part of the opening. So this is it. So incredibly small, holy cow, look at this. So take it out of the foam. This is it. It's an incredibly small device. Appropriately named the Nano, M90 Nano. Oh, here we go. Let's see. Okay. Well, there it is. It's got the ThinkCenter logo on top, if you can see that. In the front, we've got our ports. We've got a USB-C, two USB-A's, and a headphone jack. On the side, there's going to be these holes because this is the one with the fan in it. Then around back, we're going to have power. Then we're going to have a video display port. Another USB-C. Another this is USB-C, USB-A. Another USB-A and Ethernet built in. And the Kingston lock. And then this is the antenna. So this is where, if it's wireless, we'll screw the antenna in there. But look at how small this thing is. So this is the dock, our Usbc dock. Believe it or not, very similar look, but it's actually quite a bit thinner than our dock. That's how small this thing is. So with that, we got a good look at it. I'm gonna try hooking this thing up. Let's turn on the power, and then we'll show you a little bit about what this thing can do. So one thing that's pretty fascinating is you can obviously use this as a standard desktop. It's going to have all the same ports. But also, like, this is a our Tiny in One monitor. It's got capability to get a, you need to use an adapter, but you could put this in here with an adapter, which I don't have, and put it in the back of the Tiny in One monitor. Or what's really interesting also is you can use this with docking. So I'm going to try, while I'm scrambling here, to actually get this thing hooked up to the USB dock. And then we'll talk a little bit about why that's kind of a cool solution. So here's the AC, the power in here. So imagine how small this is, right, compared to a standard laptop. So the one of the ideas that we're thinking about, hold on, is are there certain situations where this might actually be easier to carry back and forth than a laptop? So what if you had this at your desk, and then at night, instead of going home and using taking your laptop with you, what if you had a Tiny and you just carry this back and forth to a docking station? So let's go ahead and hook the keyboard up to this dock like this, and the mouse up to the dock. Then we'll turn, the only thing we'll connect to this would be the USB-C. Not sure if it matters, got a couple of them here. Put that in here, and then we'll turn the power on to this. Let's see what happens here. Okay, here's a little power light on top, which is cool. Wow, it's completely quiet if it's on. Is it booting? Looks like there's power here, power there. It's supposed to be dockable. Okay, this is turning on. Let's see. Oh yeah, here we go. So this is it. Just one cable. And it's dockable. I don't know if you could get power through this or not. We're going to have to do some more testing. So those of you who have been around for a little while, you know that now I've started to run some bench testing on this. So we're going to turn off the video here in a second, get this thing fully set up, run the benchmarks, and I'll come back and share with you guys what I learned. But for now, what's interesting, we were able to get this set up, hooked up to a docking station, and booted. So let's take a break. We'll be right back. Thanks, everybody. All right, everybody, I'm back. Mind blown. So I did remove the power from the back of the thing, of the Nano, and it worked fine. So the only thing connecting currently the Nano to the monitor is the one USB-C cable, and then obviously that connects to the docking station. Then the docking station has all the other ports out of it for the monitor connection, and the USB connections for the mouse and this. So let's go ahead. We'll start this Novabench test. We'll talk a little bit more about it. So for those of you who are catching up, the last few tests I've done with the Yoga, the X1 Yoga and the X1 Carbon, I ran this test. It's getting a lot of attention. People are liking to see the numbers. Both of those products are very similar. They're both i5, you know, about the same amount of memory. I think they're 16 gigs. So this one's a little bit different because it's going to be an i7, but it's also, you know, a desktop and it's not a laptop. And it's, you can hear the fan kick in. So I don't know if you can hear that in the background, but since it's running these intensive tests, you know, you're getting, putting a lot more stress on the system, which is really exactly what we want to have happen. So I'll be curious to see what kind of score we come up with compared to the other laptop products. Just takes another minute to run through this, and then we'll be done. So I did unbox the mouse, the keyboard, the Nano that comes with it. You can see how incredibly small it is. Now we're just running the final test, and then we'll see what we come up with. So here it is. Let's see. It ran it one more time. This time we came up with a 1829. Just came up with that. You can see here it's got the Microsoft Windows 10. It's got the Intel Core i7, and it's got Intel Integrated Graphics 620. So that's a really good score on this machine. That's the highest score I've gotten yet from a Lenovo system. Excited to see it from our brand new product. Ran all the updates first, ran it through the Lenovo Vantage software, and we came up with this great score of 1829. So that's it. Signing off today. Excited to show off the brand new Lenovo Nano. And hopefully everybody thinks about this and in interesting ways they can use it in their environment. And we'll talk to everybody soon. Bye.